Hey everybody, I've been getting a lot of people asking me questions on how to change their Apple ID because some people have acquired secondhand iPhones or iPads, etc. and still have the old information on there. So, what you got to do first is you find the settings icon here on your home screen. And my camera's a bit out of focus. What you do is you press that. And you're presented here with the settings screen. If we just scroll all the way down to the bottom, near the bottom, you'll see store over here. So we just click on that and shows you this page here. So now you can see on the bottom here is the old Apple ID. That's the one we don't want. So we just click on that and pops up this little box. You can either view your Apple ID or we can sign out. So what we want to do is sign out, so just press that. And already the old iTunes account has been deactivated. So we will sign in and we can either use an existing one if you've already made one or create a new one. So for the purposes of demonstration, we will just create a new one. And we will choose which country we're in. So you could choose the store that you're in. For me, I'm in Australia, so I just click on that. Click on the done button, hide that little box, and click next to go to the next page. Cool, so now we're waiting. And here is the iTunes agreement, so you can go ahead and read that. It's pretty long. You can see as we scroll down, it's 67 pages. I've read all of it. There's nothing in there about a human sent iPad, so should be good to just click agree. This little box will pop up. Click on agree to confirm that you've read it, of course. And now you start entering your details for your new account. So we'll just make some stuff up here. So click on the email box and type in your email address. It can be a Hotmail address, a Gmail address, whatever you want. So I'm using this fake address here. It's the awesome one at Mailinator, which is a free email address thing you can use to help prevent spam. So what you have to do with your password is you have to have at least 8 characters, including a number. You have to have an uppercase letter at least, and one lowercase letter at least. Also, you can't use a dictionary word, so you can't use the word password. So if you just press the shift key here, you can enter capital letters. I'm entering the capital T, password capital P. Yep, just typing it. You can't use the word password because that's a dictionary word, so you have to have something more complicated than that. And I just add 123 on the end because you have to have a number in there. So type it in again, same as you did in the first box. The password 123, capital T, capital P. Over here you have to have a security question. This is used in case you forget your password, so you can type in whatever you want, your favorite number, your pet's name, your mother's birth country, whatever you want. For me, I'm just asking myself who is awesome. So yours truly, I'm pretty awesome. I'm sure this video is quite awesome. That'll do nicely. So enter your date of birth. So I'm just choosing anything. 1st of January 1990. 1991, whatever. Okay, let's keep scrolling down. Do you want to receive emails? This is iTunes store related emails. I don't want those. News, software updates, don't really want to get that. And then we hit next. Okay, so we wait for the next page. Okay, so this is billing information. Unfortunately, you have to have a credit card number, or you can use a coupon or a gift certificate, such as an iTunes gift certificate. You have to just enter in all these details truthfully. credit card number, security code, expiration date of your credit card, your billing address, and hit the next button. So as you, if you hit the next button before entering anything, you can see the fields that are required. You do need billing information, such as a credit card or iTunes gift card and certificate. All the fields in red you need to enter, all the ones in black are optional. So just go and fill those in. Okay, so I've just gone and entered some fake details over here. The credit card number isn't real, so don't bother. Entered that in there, expiration date. You can optionally use an iTunes gift card or certificate as opposed to a credit card. If you have your billing address, you need to have a title, Mr., Mrs., etc. First name, last name, address, postcode. I entered it wrong the first time, so I had to do it again. Enter a city and your state. So you just got to click on each box and fill in the details. For phone, there's a box you need to press first, followed by the number box. And after you've filled in all those details, hit next, such as demonstrated. Now this isn't going to work because I don't have a real credit card. Okay, so after you've legitimately entered your billing information, you can hit the next button and you'll see this. Your Apple ID has successfully been created. And then you can hit the done button and you'll be taken to the iTunes store. Here we go. So that's all it is right there. Okay, so I'm going to show you how to make Apple ID on the PC. You can go to Google and type Apple ID. Should be the first link. It's appleid.apple.com. So we can click on that. And you will be presented with this page. So we just click the big create an Apple ID button. It will pop up with this page, same deal as on the iPhone. So you enter an email address. So I will make up one, theawesomeguy@mailinator.com. Password, once again, have restrictions. So our password today will be password guy with a capital P. One, so password has to have lowercase letters too. Guy with a capital G as well, one. So once again, we have to have a capital letter in there, so, and a number, so capital P, capital G. You can't use a dictionary word such as password on its own, so we use password guy. So let's type that in. You can see there's a box to the right which will help you enter in your password. So if any of these are highlighted red, then there's something wrong. So we just enter password guy 1, capital P, capital G, and a 1 at the end because you need these. So on PC they have some questions ready here, but you can still go and write your own question, as you can see on this bottom option. So once again, who is awesome? Yours truly is awesome. Never gonna use this account again, so I don't really care. Enter a birth date. So we'll have January the 1st, and the oldest we can be is from 1901, which I don't think is old enough, but you know, whatever. So first name, middle name is optional. Guy, you enter in your address. Once again, any fields that say optional, you don't have to have. So 123 Fakes Street in Springfield. Sure, some of you people would know that. Springfield is in Massachusetts, and we just make up a zip code. Oh yeah, and at the top, I forgot to mention, you can choose your country. Language, you can change, so you can type German if you want. Yeah, as I said, you can change your country. You can type it in the box and then select your choice. Contact preferences, what emails do you want? I don't want any of these emails, so I won't tick any of them. Entering the security code, letters are not case sensitive, you can see over here. So for instance, I can change this G to a lowercase g, or this D to a lowercase d, and it won't really matter. read the terms and conditions and tick this box, and then we click the Create Apple ID button. And now we have to verify email. So depending on your email address, or your setup, you can go into Outlook or you can use your webmail. So we can go Hotmail, or we can go to your Gmail account, or whatever you had as your Apple ID email address. For me, I use Mailinator, so I'll get my emails from here. You'll receive an email from Apple. Subject will be please verify contact email address. So we'll just click on that email. And sorry about that. This is what it should look like. So, dear awesome guy, blah, 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 blah. And there's a verify now button. So we click on that to verify our new email address that is associated with our Apple ID. And then we are taken back here. So we have to type in our new Apple ID. So I'll type it in, and a password. So password guy1, capital P, capital G1, verify address. And now the email address has been verified and a new Apple account has been created. So if you've made an account on PC, you can click on sign in after you've signed out and press the use existing Apple ID button. So what you'll be doing is you'll be entering your email and password for the Apple ID you created on your PC. So I'll just go into that now. So I have to awesomeness. Sorry, my camera's going out of focus there. At Mailinator. Mailinator.com. And my password, of course, you need a capital letter in there and lowercase letters, at least one, and you have to have a number. It needs to be at least 8 characters long and not a dictionary word. So after you've entered those details in, you press OK. This box will pop up saying you need to review your information before you sign into the iTunes store. So we'll just go and click the review button. Now this should look familiar to you. So it will pop up with the page where you select your country for your store. We've seen that before. I'll choose Australia and hit next. And now it will load the iTunes store agreement. Gotta go read that, of course. Go through all 67 pages and then hit the agree button. This will pop up. Confirm that you'll agree, and then you need to enter your billing information. So you go and do that, and then you hit the next button. Okay, so I'll quickly show you how to update apps. So you can click the App Store. You'll see over here in the corner, you'll see updates. We can update a single app by clicking on the app, and then there will be a little update button in the corner. So we can click on that and enter in your password when it pops up for your iTunes account and press OK. I won't be doing that because you can also click update all to update all your apps and enter your password. I'll go do that now. Now what you might realize is you might need to restart your phone, I think, for the new account to take effect if you've changed your Apple ID. I haven't done that, but you enter your password. This might come up, so this is new. Just press OK. And just follow that information. iTunes Store. This is unexpected. Just agree because some stuff has changed since I last signed in with this account. Okay, ignore that. So we can click the update all button and it will possibly ask us for our password and it will update these apps. Now one of the apps, this has popped up, I haven't purchased it was on the last account that was on this phone, Smart Sync. So I can't update that. If I want to update that, I'll need to sign in with an account that has purchased it.